Hey everyone, John here. Welcome back. Particle Illusion 2024.5 is out, and in it we've made working with particles easier than ever before, especially when it comes to moving them around on the stage. So let's take a look. In recent releases, we've added gradient presets and overlife graph presets, both of which dramatically speed up workflow in Particle Illusion. In 2024.5, we've now made moving particles easier by adding position path presets. And we've included a variety of new and useful path presets that you can view from different directions to understand how the particles will be positioned in 3D space. After applying a preset, the new position path transform feature automatically opens, and this allows you to scale, rotate, and reposition the entire path. And if you want to make changes later, you can open it at any time by right-clicking on any position parameter. And if you've chosen or created a path that doesn't exit the frame, you can use the new Stop Emission When Motion Ends option, which keyframes the particle number down to zero when the emitter reaches the end of the path. Position path presets can be applied to any position parameter, including camera position. So this is actually an easy way to add camera motion without needing to manually animate it. New timing adjustment features help you fine-tune your particle's movement, including a new Equalize Path Timing feature that helps you even out the speed of particles along the path. You can adjust the animation timing of a single parameter like position by right-clicking on the parameter and selecting Scale Parameter Animation Timing. As you adjust it, you'll see the emitter update, or you can look at the scale duration. If the emitter contains multiple animated parameters and you want to scale the animation timing of all of them, use the Scale Emitter Animation Timing menu item. And if your project contains multiple emitters or other objects with animated parameters, scale all of the animation timing of everything in the project using the Action menu item. In 2024.5, the position data is now displayed in the graph view. You can switch between the X, Y, and Z values, and you can make changes here instead of in the stage. Whether you're using a position path preset, or you've created your own custom path, what if you wanted to replace the emitter? Well, you can use the new Replace with Library Emitter function for that. All you do is select your emitter, and you can preview it in the preview window, and then right-click on the emitter node and choose Replace with Library Emitter. A related feature that may help you choose the right library emitter is the recording and playback of the motion in the preview. Click the record icon and then click and drag around in the preview. When you release the mouse button, playback will start automatically and will continue until you stop it. So this allows you to try out different emitters without needing to drag around in the preview. All of these enhancements make working in Particle Illusion 2024.5 easier, and we've improved things in other areas too, including making parameters easier to find. A new parameter search option has been added in the parameter panel, which you can use to show only the parameters you're looking for, or you can highlight them in place. And if you've ever been confused about how color gradients work with alpha gradients, this has been addressed as well. In 2024.5, you'll now see the resultant gradient, which shows you exactly what will be happening with the particles over their life. Notice that this resultant gradient will also show in the graph view when a particle over life parameter is selected, so that you can see the relationship between size and color, for instance. And if you've had projects where you've worked with multiple different particles, you may have found that the sprite information on the particle node doesn't give you much information. Now you can click and hold on that thumbnail, and you'll see a larger preview of the sprite with all its details. And if the sprite contains multiple frames, you'll see those automatically too. And finally, we've made some great updates to the particle engine in 2024.5. Inherited velocity now gives smoother results. Sprites that have Keep Aligned to Motion selected work in all cases, including fluids. And 3D lines, which we added in 2024, are higher quality. You can also boost opacity values, cranking up the brightness of sparks and other hot particles. Plus, we've added brand new blending modes, including screen, overlay, subtract, and more, opening up brand new creative possibilities. Alright, so that's just a quick look at some of the things that are new in Particle Illusion 2024.5. To learn more or to download a free trial version, be sure to visit borisfx.com.